Now, here's Chief Meteorologist Tony Petrarca with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 Futurecast.
All right, pretty busy here in the Weather Center. A lot to cover. Let's get started. First with this evening, I mean, heading out, perhaps you go into water fire, you see the Doppler radar, and it's like, oh no, a rainy night. More than likely not. A lot of these showers are brief, and they should not last much longer. They're going to be diminishing over the next couple of hours. So water fires, go ahead, grab a jacket, though it should be a lot colder. And notice the showers are just that. They're spotty, they're scattered, and in between, we actually have some rays of sunshine, so not out of the question next hour or two to catch a rainbow in some communities. Now, notice some flecks of yellow, some brief downpours. We've even had reports of some very small, tiny hail, not severe hail that breaks tree limbs and things like that, just little pellets of ice coming out of the sky and some of these heavier showers. And again, diminishing. You see the camera lens shaking, you know, a shower off in the distance, sunshine, then the other side of the sky, kind of the perfect recipe for sometimes getting a rainbow. We'll see if it happens. In the meantime, temperatures upper 40s to low 50s, but I'm tracking a cold front, the leading edge of colder air, so it'll turn a lot colder later on this evening. In Oakland Beach and Warwick, it is dry for now with dark clouds mixing with sunshine. As far as Sunday and the timing and all this, Sunday morning actually looks fine, heading out to services and things like that. Dry skies, no travel problems. Sunday afternoon, especially late day, the light snow starts. Overall travel most of the afternoon hours on Sunday should be okay, but the worst of this storm in terms of precipitation, snow, even some rain mixing in along with strong gusty wind would be Sunday night into very early on Monday morning. I'll give you an idea of some accumulations in just a second. You see the widely scattered showers coming through right now. Here's the cold front, the leading edge of the cooler air coming in for later tonight. Now, I'm tracking an area of moisture across the southern plains and the Gulf. Both of these areas of moisture will come together, consolidate into a developing storm off the Carolina coastline on Sunday. The exact track will determine how this all plays out for Sunday night into Monday morning. Why snow? Look over the border in Canada. That's the cold air needed for snow. And that'll be dropping down overnight into the weekend, and that sets up for a messy Sunday night. Take a look at Futurecast. We're going to start off this evening, watch the showers diminish. Skies are clearing out. This is Saturday morning. You're looking good, bright and cold. This is Saturday afternoon, looking nice. Sunshine, though chilly, but dry. Jump ahead to Sunday morning. Still dry, but then here comes your storm system. Late day, early evening. This is around 6 o'clock in the evening. The snow overspreading the area and the area of low pressure offshore intensifying with steady and heavy wet snow mixing with rain near the coastline later on Sunday night into early on Monday morning. Definite impact for the early morning commute on Monday. Getting real close. And again, tonight's clearing out. It's a dry and cold at night. And for tomorrow morning, we're looking okay with sunshine, a chilly start, starting off in the upper 20s. And then temperatures will be rising through the 30s and 40s, eventually topping out at only 40 to 45 tomorrow afternoon. So it's bright and cool. How much snow? This would be the amount by actually late Sunday night into Monday morning. Potential statewide of 4 to 6 inches of snow with 1 to 3 the lower Cape and Islands if we get that mixed with rain and sleet. My best advice, do not let this be the last forecast that you see. We have all of tomorrow to analyze weather data, so these numbers may have to go up or down. You see the stormy weather on Sunday, Sunday evening, Sunday night, things winding down on Monday afternoon at 39, and then a gradual warming trend by midweek with temperatures approaching the mid-50s. Now, we're talking about a storm that really hasn't even formed yet. It's not even on the map on the East Coast. So again, check back with us later tonight. Again, tomorrow and tomorrow night. As you know, the drill, sometimes those numbers have to be shifted up or down, but that is the first early call, and that would be on the first day, the first full day of spring.
I think people put their shovels, snow blowers away, took the plows off.
Not yet. Winter's last hurrah.
All right. Thank you, Tony.
Okay.
We have more.